he's the nation's ringmaster in chief on Friday night. And stars from around the world know that an evening on his sofa will always be a lot of fun. He also helps us to appreciate the lighter side of European music. He's BBC One's go-to guy for the big event. He's been entertaining us now for nearly 20 years, and television is a brighter landscape because of his wit, his moistness, his warmth, and his talent. Let's have a look at him doing what he does best.
Quick, kind,
funny,
crazy,
magnificent,
never can,
naughty, and naughty.
They remembered. Let's have the show!
Hi, I'm Nicole Kidman.
Hi, I'm Ben Affleck.
Hello, I'm Tom Hanks.
Hi, I'm Tom Cruise, and welcome to the Graham Norton Show.
It's just such a treat. One of those shows that you really have in your mind, a little sort of countdown. Oh, it's only, you know, 3 hours to go or whatever.
I know, it's good, right? It's good. It's a good one. They might just clap for 45 minutes. It's good.
All those possibly quite poker-faced people, especially from Hollywood, come onto that show and just enjoy that sense of mirth and freedom.
Why are you wearing lipstick on top here?
Just makes you feel so relaxed. And even when you're exhausted, somehow it's like diving into a glass of champagne, you know, the bubbles just kind of raise you up.
By the way, this is the best time I've ever had on the talk show.
You don't feel as if you're being interviewed, you just feel as if you're going to have a bit of a party.
Now, Judy, do you still go clubbing? Do you still cut a rug?
Do you know, I've never, ever been to a club in my life.
And I genuinely thought I'd never been to a club before.
Yes, you have. Where? I bumped into you
with
in heaven.
You? Oh. Oh, yes, you did.
And so, you see, I was caught out.
They took us in through the back door.
Wouldn't they?
Story of her life.
There's a tennis match that's happening when you're doing a talk show.
Famously, you performed the title rap.
Yeah, it's not just questions and answers. And he's just magnificent at understanding who's sitting in front of him enough to set the table for you to win. Story of the night, my life just went straight upside down. And I'd like to take a minute, just sit right there and tell you how I became the prince of a town called Bel-Air.
Whoa! He just knows how to work a room, and he keeps a sort of very good control on things. You don't see the workings of what he does. That's what's so clever about him.
He's a very personable chap. You like him on and off screen. He's a really nice guy, which you don't always get.
This is a puppet, Ed.
When I shot the Sing video, I had a puppet made, and he had the puppet on the show.
It does look
quite... Is
this
where you're going to do your talent now?
Yeah. Yeah, Amanda.
You never quite know what's going to happen, and all the time anyway, you're waiting for that ghastly red chair.
They'd be upset if I didn't. Yeah.
Where do they go, Graham?
Where do they go?
So unfair. Gosh, it makes me laugh.
He's a little bit cruel. You're a little bit acerbic sometimes.
I was on a safari in one of the jeeps.
Can I just stop you? Is that where you got that coat?
But it comes with such incredible kind of warmth and humanity that no one ever really feels bad, you know.
I feel like I want to believe, but I like Siobhan.
There's no record of show business in the family at all. But he was always trying to make people laugh. And he got up his first Christmas at school, at the school concert. And I don't know if you've ever heard of I'm a Little Teapot. And he did that, complete with actions, got great applause.
Graham trained. He went to drama school. Let's not forget that.
Ebony and ivory, together in perfect harmony.
That was real quality, Father Noel.
Will you dance then? Come on, Tony, sit on the old Riverdance album.
Actually,
Father Ted was his big moment, and that definitely was a wonderful help to him.
What age would you say I am? Go on, guess. Well, what age would you say? Don't you tell him. He knows the good I'd like to tell him. No. Go on, guess. What would you say?
40.
And Graham comes from a live background. You know, he started out on the circuit, he started doing the clubs.
What have you never done?
I have never kissed Keanu Reeves.
Try.
I fear you never will.
I think that's why he's so at ease standing up in front of a group of people.
I'll take that home and put it in my music room. I actually have a place when people give me stuff like that. There's so many things that I have to say about Graham Norton. I had the most fun with him when he came to Dollywood. I think of all the people I've worked with, I think I probably have more in common with Graham than anybody else. So needless to say, people look at us like a little couple, and I just love him. Sail away with me to another world,
and we rely on each other. He's utterly unique, Graham Norton. He's incredibly important to BBC One. When you launch a big new show like Let It Shine, it's brilliant knowing you've got Graham as that big supporting host. And he does pull it together.
Working with Graham is just so much fun. It's like not really working. We can't quite believe that we've got away with it, to be honest.
I think as soon as we saw Graham doing Eurovision, it felt like an absolutely natural step. So Terry was delighted to see Graham fall into that role. He felt like a natural successor.
It's the twinkle, isn't it? You've got to have the twinkle.
It's like a bit of corrugated shed has been blown off a roof and hit her in the neck.
For him, it's a real moment in the diary, and he enjoys every minute of it.
I tell you, if that doesn't put a smile on your face, you are dead inside. The commentary box was rocking.
I think he'd be thrilled to win this award, and he'd be really shocked.
The great thing about him is he has not changed. He is the same guy that he was all those years ago.
You think Graham is a chat show host, Saturday Night Entertainment, he's an agony aunt, he's a radio DJ, he's a novelist. You kind of go, what is it that Graham can't do?
I go a long, 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 long way to spend an hour with Graham. I just can't be there this evening.
No, I'm very proud of him. But, I mean, I'm not the type that go around telling anybody that. So don't tell anybody.
Ladies and gentlemen, the nation's heartthrob, Mr. Graham Norton.